everyone. This is Joana, and happy holidays. This is your reading for December 2016. I cannot believe it's the end of the year. I mean, this is just crazy. I'm going to also, in the love reading, pull a card, of course, from the Romance Angel Oracle cards, besides using the Rider-Waite deck. So I am trying. I've been so late with my videos. I usually try to get them out, you know, in the middle of the month. So I am doing my best to get these out to you. I want to thank you all for those who have ordered a reading from me. And I really thank you for all the subscribers that have hung in there with me. I really appreciate it very much. And then I want to welcome my new subscribers, of course. So, all right. Well, let's get on with your December reading. Thank you so much. All right. Bye. Hi, Aquarius. This is your love reading for December 2016. And I'm doing something a bit different. The spread has slightly been altered, but I'm going around three times. And sometimes I'll go around one time and I'm led to stop and give some messages. Then I'll go around a second time. I might be stopped. If not, I'll go around one last time. But what I want to clarify is that each time that I go around, whatever messages I give to you still hold true. So it'll hold true for somebody out there. And then the second or the third time, or how many, you know, I might just do all, put out all the cards and then do a reading. But whatever messages, if I stop, those are still true for somebody. So I wanted to clarify. Also, remember that I am reading for thousands of you. So if these readings don't resonate, watch your moon and or rising sign. And of course, Aquarius, if you would like a private reading with me, I would love to do one for you. You can reach me at my website, moonwatertarot.com. I also do offer the questions, the private video questions, anywhere from 1 to 4 questions. So, all right. Well, let's get started here for December love, Aquarius. Aquarius, what is the most important messages for Aquarius for love in December 2016? Okay, let's take a look here. Oops, I'm so sorry. Just hit the... Let me make sure you can see this also, because trying to get it so you can see everything, and sometimes it's challenging. Okay. Okay, let's see what comes out. The Hermit. The Knight of Wands. The 9 of Wands. Interesting that we have 2 9s here. And the 5 of Swords. Okay. This is the card, you know, if you watch my channel, I always look at the underlying card in the deck as the theme. Since I'm going around three times, I don't want to just flip everything over. Wow, the Ace of Cups. Okay, let me make sure you can see this. All right, so we have the Hermit here. The Hermit for me is the sign of Virgo. Now, it's interesting that there's 2 9s, 10. So far everything adds up to a 6. where it's there may be something that needs to be resolved is kind of a feeling that I'm getting. Feel like somebody is offering, or there is the offer of love, but what I'm getting, it could be a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. This may not be happening also. I want to make this clear. This may not be happening directly to you. Let's just say that there's a situation where maybe you're dating somebody or seeing someone. And it could also be, I'm picking up that it could be that someone is offering them something. So I wanted to say that, but I feel like it's more that there is either you're offering someone something and they're needing some time alone. But the way I'm feeling it more as you're wanting some time alone, you need to get clarity on a situation, and it could be dealing with your past, somebody from your past. It could also be that there's been some type of fallout or an argument, especially, you know, with the 2 9s sometimes, and with the Hermit here, there may be a need to spend some time alone, figure things out. And I think it's also doing some introspection, some gaining higher knowledge, using your wisdom. This is not a process that, you know, happens overnight. I think that you might be kind of on the defense, or, you know, guarding, may even be guarding your heart or guarding a situation. Could also be that somebody around you, you know, you might need some time alone, and this person is battling or fighting for your love, or they're not giving up, they're persevering. You might want to withdraw, and they're just like, no, wait a second. I'm still here, you know? And it could be that, you know, you need some time alone to kind of figure things out about this person. Maybe there's been some recent conflicts or some, disagreements, or somebody's putting some type of demands on you, or even some jealousy. I mean, you know, here we have three people. So, you know, somebody may be trying to woo you or win you over at all cost. But let me put out more cards and just see what other information I'm getting. Oh, wow. Okay. I have the Four of Wands, the Two of Swords, the Page of Swords, and the King of Pentacles. All right, let me look here for a second. I am feeling that some of you are kind of definitely at a crossroads. There may be somebody that is trying to kind of be a bit obstinate, almost as if I feel like they know what's best for you, instead of, you know, you listening to your own inner guidance, or maybe they're very persuasive. These are in my challenge position. And I think that it's going to be important that you are aware of what is going on around you. Because I almost feel like somebody is slowly moving themselves in, possibly into your house, It may not be, or apartment, it may not be a physical house. It could be more mental, emotional, or spiritual. And you might be saying, I don't know if I'm ready for that, but they're not listening to you. Also, I feel like it's important. Somebody may, feel like, I hear somebody saying, well, you know, I'm old, or I'm wiser, I know what's best for you. And I feel like somebody even may be talking about marriage or proposing, but, you know, I feel like you're not quite sure about this. You're indecisive. You're a little bit stuck. This, you know, these cards are almost like in reverse. Sometimes, and this could be a fire sign. It's interesting. We have fire, air, and we have earth. Just to let you know, and we also do have cups here, although it's not a person, but it's an offer or somebody trying to extend their hand. The waters are Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, air, Gemini, of course, you, Aquarius, and Libra, wands, Sagittarius, Leo, and Aries, and pentacles, Capricorn, Virgo, and Taurus. So, you know, I also do feel like somebody is possibly doing some kind of investigating about somebody. So maybe this is somebody that you haven't seen or met face to face, or you've talked on the phone. But I do feel, and it could be also this person back here, as opposed, and there may be three suitors with the number three, and we have three individuals here, and we've got the Knight of Wands, the Page of Swords, and the King of Pentacles. But I kind of feel like somebody, if it's not an investigation, or trying to learn more about somebody, I feel like somebody's possibly like on Facebook or the internet, or, you know, they're trying to, they're watching from afar. Maybe you're watching from afar on somebody that, you know, hastily, especially here in the reverse position, the Knight of Wands can be very hasty. And in some aspects, it's the opposite, where, you know, here he is hasty, or she, moving forward with passion, abundance, and with a lot of energy. But things in reverse, because it's my challenge position, it's almost as if these cards are reverse. Maybe things are stuck. They're not quite moving forward. And so you're taking a pause. You know, you need to kind of find your own self, your own path, before all this other thing, you know, other stuff happens. Maybe there's a conflict that you're dealing with somebody, or somebody who's jealous, and, you know, you're trying to kind of go into, hiding, the hermit, removing yourself from the situation. And for others, this could be a conflict within yourself too. But let's do one more round and we'll see what we get. Wow, four right next to a four, just like we had a nine right next to a nine. Okay. Oh my gosh, and another four. It's in the challenge position too. It's the Emperor. Could also be that maybe somebody is not quite, well, you know, we have three fours here now that I'm looking at it. I think that, well, let me put out the rest. Oh, the High Priestess. Listen, listen, listen to your intuition, and look at that, Justice. There may be some type of investigation going on. There's something to be seen. There's something to be learned and seen that in the challenge position you're not looking at, or you don't want to see, or you don't want to face, or somebody else doesn't want to face. Maybe somebody else doesn't want to face that there is a situation that, especially with the five, where there's so much conflict that you want it to be over. With the Justice card, the truth is coming out in December. And it could be that there is a legal matter, there's conflicts. Maybe there is some legal situation. It could be with the page here around children, child custody, child support. It could also be legal situation regarding, I feel like there could be somebody like trying to evict somebody, like they've lived together or both names are on the lease, but they want the person out is another thing I'm picking up. And another thing is I feel like there is a situation that somebody's really trying to move forward, but I get push and pull, like they're moving forward, but your intuition saying, wait a second, we need to slow this down. You know, like you are feeling a bit overwhelmed. There's more to be seen or to learn about this person. There may be a legal situation going on regarding money or regarding a home that may be affecting a relationship or finances. Another message that I'm getting is there's definitely a move. So that could be a physical move. I think that somebody possibly in a relationship may have moved up to a higher position, especially with the King of Pentacles. It may require somebody like the family to move, or they're asking you to move and you're not sure if you want to. Or maybe you're a little upset because they are moving because of work. It may be a very demanding job. It may be where there's a lot of legalities, you know, or a big, you know, capital city where laws are made or government work. And maybe they can't or they aren't asking you to move with them. And it's created a lot of conflict. And you just kind of have to decide what it is, you know, that you're wanting, if you're going, and I just feel this sense of withdrawal. Now on a positive note, I want to say this, I feel like there is somebody out there where there's somebody wants to get married and the other person isn't ready yet. But I also feel like there is the possibility of marriage. Now, it may not be in the traditional sense. I feel like it could just be somebody's going down to the city hall, or you're working on getting a marriage license or all the paperwork, and it's, you know, it's not going to be a big to do with the Emperor here. I almost feel like somebody is secretively either they know they're pregnant and they're hiding it. Or that, they don't know they're pregnant. But I feel more like somebody is going to find out. Now, I'm also getting the message that it could be with the Emperor, and this being in my challenge position and in reverse, there may be challenges regarding this, situation in terms of maybe there is not approval from the family somehow, or there's because the Emperor in reverse, it could also be that the person that you're with is not good at maintaining boundaries, so there's a lot of messages here. I do think, though, that somebody is definitely being asked to either get married, There's an engagement, but I think what's important is that I feel like there's a lot of secrets going on. There's a lot of wisdom here, a lot of spirituality, and to really kind of, not just with the hermit, the high priestess is also one that very much is very intuitive, very knowledgeable, and goes within. And so I think it's important that if somebody is trying to rush you into something, because I'm hearing like a gunshot wedding, that you kind of take a step back and really listen to your intuition. And is this the right person for you? Some of you, it definitely is. But there's some type of conflict going on, whether it's inner conflict, whether it's conflict because the family, or maybe there's a grandfather or fatherly figure that would you believe would not approve. But you know, with this card and it being in the upright position, there may be, you know, a sense of a loss in some way, or in order to allow this to come in, you've got to let this go out. And so that's why there's a two here, because the Justice card also represents a big decision. And here we have a two also. So we've got the High Priestess, which it represents a big decision also. So you may be at a crossroads when it comes to love, and maybe by taking a step back, taking a breather, getting insight into the situation, really getting in touch with what, you know, you want, because you might be on two different paths. And really, you know, love this person and vice versa, but something is interfering, or there's some changes. There's some resolution that has to come in order for this to start flowing. So let's just see. With the cards, the Doreen Virtues Romance Angel cards, and see what comes. Oh my goodness. Okay. Four flew out, but two flew up in the upright. Okay. So let's go with these. The two that flipped out over. It is safe for you to love. Oh my gosh. Okay. Three. Oh, okay. Deception. Someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship. Maybe that's why he's getting so many secrets. And that's why the truth, you know, or insight will be revealed. Unrequited love. It's unrequited love, I heard. There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. So, you know, this is kind of answering everything that I was talking about, because I feel like there's something that, you know, like I said earlier, somebody is trying to kind of make a situation happen. You're on two different paths. Like they're trying to, you know, will you move into me? I know what's best for you. I want us to live together. And you're like the hermit. You're needing some time and space. Again, also with the secrets that I kept picking up. I remember I said there's something for you to learn, for you to see, listen to your inner guidance. Because someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship. I feel like it's the other person. I don't feel like it's you, but You are feeling like you kind of have to go along with things because of pressure, and maybe it's pressure from a family member. That you're feeling that, or, you know, if there's a situation where you're pregnant, you find out you're pregnant, and you know, there may be pressure with that. If you're not married, of course. So really listen to your inner guidance, and then it's safe for you to love. Open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all. Well, this to me right away, what I heard was also self-love. But, you know, I do kind of get the feeling, like I said earlier, like somebody is possibly hovering, you have to resolve that conflict so that it is safe for you to move on, and there may be definitely your king or queen waiting for you. And it could be an earth sign, Capricorn, Virgo, or Taurus. But these cards are very important. They like I said, they really kind of cover the gamut of what I was talking about, because I feel like for somebody, love is being offered. And there is, you know, a celebration going on. But listen to your inner voice, and don't do something because you feel like you have to. Really, this is time to really listen to yourself. This can also represent a mentor or a spiritual mentor. You know, somebody that's got a lot of wisdom that may be able to help you. So that may be somebody also that's coming into your life to help you get through this or to help resolve the situation. But I do feel that, you know, there is somebody that is possibly definitely moving or moving in together, or somebody has offered that, or even, like I said earlier, proposal in marriage. So, all right. Well, I hope this reading helps you, Aquarius. Remember, if this does not apply to you, I apologize. I try to give as many messages as I can. If, of course, you like a personal reading, I'd love to do one for you. And you can, again, reach me at my website, moonwatertarot.com. So thank you so much for watching. And I wish you the very best. Take good care of yourself. All right. Bye.